This is the world that we live in, though. We have to care about everyone's feelings, everyone's tolerances, everyone's intolerances, everyone's dietary requirements. I'll tell you where it's gone too far, and I have to be the person to say this. For the love of God, we have got enough milks now. Would everyone stop milking shit? I went to buy a coffee recently, near to where I live, in London, very rough part of London called Notting Hill. I went in there. I have very straightforward coffee tastes. It should have been a very straightforward transaction. It was anything but. I went in there. I was like, hello, I'd like a white coffee, please. Okay, sir, what kind of milk would you like with your coffee? We've got a coconut milk. We've got an almond nut milk. We've got a hazelnut milk. We've got a cashew nut milk. We've got a macadamia nut milk. We've got an oat milk, rice milk, hemp milk, soy milk. You can have it from a bean, from a pulse, from a nut, from a grain, from an oat, from a flax, from a leaf, from a seed, from a tree. I'd like it from a nipple, please. I don't care what type of nipple, preferably a cow's, but I'm not fussy. I'll take it from whatever nipple I can get. She looked at me like I had requested it from hers. Like I was the weirdo. I'm not the weirdo. You're the one that's in the back of the shop with your little friends milking fucking cashew nuts. You're the freaks, not me. I do not for one moment doubt that lactose intolerance is a very grave and pressing issue for humanity. But lest I remind you, we currently don't have a cure for cancer, and there are 12 readily available milk substitutes on the market, which I would argue is 11 more than we need. And look, we're all having fun. I don't want to turn my special into a TED talk. But I'm about to hit you up with some pretty sophisticated science here. Milk must come from a tit. Last time I checked, the almond, pretty flat-chested. You are drinking nut juice. Oh dear. I worry this may be a little bit of a London problem. On this tour that I've been doing, I bring this up because I was in the northeast of England and we were doing a show there and we were staying in this tiny little hotel in the middle of nowhere. It was amazing. There was a slightly older gentleman that was serving us breakfast at this hotel. And my tour manager, Johnny, asked him about the milk situation. He got the best response I've ever heard. He was like, excuse me, what are the milk options? The guy went, hot or cold? Where are the dairy drinkers in? Who's a dairy drinker in here this evening? You do realize we are the smokers of 2020. Seriously, watch as we get slowly ostracized from society. They'll give us our own designated areas to go and drink our dirty titty milk in. They'll have warnings soon, like they did with the cigarettes. You're going to the supermarket, pick up a carton of milk, there'll be a sticker on the side of it. Warning, may cause healthy bones and teeth. And don't you dare in 2020 drink your disgusting titty milk through a plastic straw. Oh, no. You may as well be sucking it directly from the devil's dick. I got that lecture recently from a friend of mine. A friend of mine who's the classic environmental hypocrite. I don't know whether you've ever come across this woman. She gives it all the, yeah, I've got my reusable coffee cup and my reusable water bottle all in my eco-friendly grocery bag. You drove here in a fucking Hummer. She comes to me about the straw. She's like, Jack, you can't use a plastic straw anymore. What about the environment? What about the wildlife? You need a reusable straw. So I was like, okay, fine, understood. I went, I got myself a reusable straw. It's made of ivory. It works a fucking treat. doing my bit, doing my bit. Don't use a coffee cup anymore. I just take my turtle shell into Starbucks. I'm like, fill that bad boy up. And I've started recycling condoms. So, yeah, the big man knows what I'm talking about. Quick rinse, get rid of any nut juice, stick it on the washing line. It's a bag for life. We've got to do our bit. We've got to do our bit now. I had the vegan Impossible Burger the other day. Oh, my God, amazing. Here's the twist. Tastes just like a regular hamburger, but it's the price of two hamburgers. And guilt-free. Plus, you can get any topping you like. I went for bacon and foie gras. Because that, of course, is the answer. We should all be going vegan. My flatmate, Hugo, recently, of course. Hugo, I'm just a normal guy. No, the Hugster, he's great. He lives in the East Wing, and... anyway, he's a vegan, but here's the thing. He didn't want to call himself a vegan because he was worried that some of his friends might give him shit. So, instead of calling himself a vegan, Hugo decided that he was going to identify as, get ready for it, because it is a humdinger. Plant positive. Oh, nice work, Hugo. Successfully sidestepped the wanker bullet there, didn't we? And it's now literally every other word out of his mouth. He's like, Jack, you can make as many jokes as you like about me being plant positive. I am going to live 10 years longer than you. Yeah, not if you keep calling yourself plant positive around me. I will smother you in your sleep. Actually, I won't even need to smother you now. You're a vegan. I'll just place the cushion on your face. You'll be too weak to lift it off. You're suffocating me. Nope, just making you oxygen negative. It's not good crying over spilt nut juice. Where are the vegans at? We got vegans in? Okay, wow, an army of them, oh dear. I'm gonna get booed off stage in a hail of tofu. I'm sorry, I honestly am. I come in peace, okay? I don't want any beef, and quite frankly, neither do you. That's vegan bashing, that's what that was. And it is, excuse the pun, low-hanging fruit. Because, look, there is no denying your life choice, 100% better for you, better for the world. I also know why. Human beings have a pop at vegans. It's a very simple human instinct. As human beings, we basically just can't bear anyone else that has exercised any degree of self-control. And you all fucking do it. Doesn't matter what that self-control is. Someone that's become a vegan, someone that's given up drinking, someone that's running a marathon, someone that has started cycling to work. Your mouth goes, oh, good for you. And your head goes, cunt.